Yo, you guys have no idea how happy I am right now. All right, literally, my most highly anticipated feature, maybe since I first started playing this game, is coming to global much sooner than I had originally thought. I mean, I knew it was coming at some point in August, but I thought it was going to be at the end of the month, you know, closer to the 24th, 25th, right before the download celebration started. But instead, it looks like we're going to be getting it in a couple days from now. I mean, I don't think there's an exact date in the news, but it's soon, guys. It's very, very soon. With update 4.11.1, we will be getting, finally, the Link Levels system. All right, I mean, I've been watching my JP friends over the past couple of weeks just have so much fun with it, having a grand old time, you know, leveling up their units, Link levels from 1 to 10, posting their showcases, their streams, their screenshots on Instagram and Twitter, just rubbing it in my face as a global main. And I was jealous, man, not gonna lie. I mean, I was sticking to my loyalty to global. I wasn't gonna switch over to the JP side, but it was getting harder and harder to be patient. And this just feels like an early Christmas present. All right, it feels like Christmas in July. Actually, it's August now, so Christmas in August, because I couldn't have asked for a better present from Bandai. Honestly, like, I'm just so freaking stoked that we're finally getting this, that my fellow global players, you guys, can actually experience this as well. If anybody that, you know, hasn't been following the JP side doesn't really know what this whole Link level system is about and why I'm so excited for it, let me quickly explain. All right, so essentially, once this update drops, we'll be able to level up the Link skills for each of our individual units from level 1 to level 10. So when I say Link skills, of course, I mean like Fierce Battle, Legendary Power, Prepare for Battle, and so on and so forth. And as we level up these Link skills from 1 to 10, they get stronger and stronger, the boosts get bigger and bigger, and they're not insignificant, right? Like, these are some pretty impactful changes. So for a Link like Fierce Battle, for example, it goes from 15% attack at level 1, which is what it's currently at, to 20% attack at level 10, and that's a pretty huge boost right there. And then for something like Big Bad Bosses, which is one of the best Links in the game, but the issue with it is that there's an HP restriction, right? So at level 1, which is the current state, you have to be below 80% HP to get that massive 25% attack and defense boost. But when you level it to level 10, that HP restriction is completely removed. So you just straight up get 25% attack and defense, and that's it, which is just insane, dude. 25% attack and defense with no restriction is just crazy, right? And then of course, every other Link in the game has a similar effect where they get bigger boosts or more ki or so on and so forth. I mean, different Links have different effects, so you really have to look at a full list to get the full idea, but that's kind of the concept. The Links get better, the units get more and more OP, and there's some units in this game that really didn't need it, like LR Vegito Blue, for example, or LR Blue Gogeta, Super Saiyan Blue Kakun Goku, and Super Saiyan Blue Evolution Vegeta. I mean, you can name a bunch of them, right? Like, these guys did not need boosts, but they're getting them because of this Link level system. And oh, by the way, the best part about this, I can't even talk anymore. The best part about this, in my opinion, is the fact that this is a completely free-to-play system. I mean, they totally could have made it pay to win. They could have made us like summon for materials or do something kind of like the Zenkai system on Dragon Ball Legends, where you essentially have to spend like a ton of summoning currency to fully max out a unit, right? But for this Link level system on Dokkan, all you gotta do is bring the units you wanna level up Link skills for on a team, bring them on events, and just use them, you know, run them to fight enemies, beat stages, and that's how you level up their Link skills. Like, it's completely free to play. All it takes is some time and effort and grinding, essentially, which is okay, because like I said, man, I'm running out of things to do. Actually, I don't know if I said that in this video, but I'm running out of things to do in Dokkan. Like, these days, unless there's a new celebration, new events, I'm just logging in and doing the daily missions and logging out, because there's just nothing else for me to do, unless I'm making a video, of course, which is a different case. But for the most part, it's just kind of bland, right? It's kind of bare. But this Link level system allows us to just do something at all times. It just gives us something to do with our stamina, something to do with our time, to, you know, run different units that we wouldn't have run normally because we want to level up their link skills and all that stuff, right? So I think it's awesome. I think it's one of the best things that they could have done to add more replayability to the game. And I'm just so glad we're finally getting it, man, and sooner than expected. So that's kind of a quick synopsis of this link level system. And of course, once the full system drops, I'll probably do another video to give you guys a more in-depth overview of the different link effects and all that stuff. But for now, I think that's enough. And there's also some stuff in the news about some other changes to just links in general, which we can take a look at here. So let's click on this one first. So it says, "Dear players, thank you for your passionate support." And then it says, "Along with the implementation of the link skill level system, the effects of certain link skills will also be adjusted in update 4.11.1. So there's some links, like some older links, that are having just their straight up like effects changed or boosted because they're outdated or something else, right? So here's a full list of all the links that are being changed. There's the students, which before adjustment was defense plus 1,000. After adjustment, defense plus 20%. So it went from a flat boost of 1,000 to 20% defense. Huge upgrade. Crane School goes from 500 attack to 15% attack. Golden Warrior goes from key plus 1, enemy defense minus 2,000, to all enemies, defense minus 5%, and key plus 1. When they meet the eye, goes from 300 attack to attack plus 10%. Messenger from the Future goes from 500 attack to 5% attack. World Tournament Reborn goes from 300 attack to 15% attack. New goes from 200 attack to 20% attack. Saiyan Warrior Race goes from 700 attack to 5% attack. Respect goes from 500 attack to 15% attack. Android Assault goes from 100 or 1,000 attack to 10% defense. Wait, what? Goes from 1,000 defense to 10% defense. Turtle School goes from plus 500 attack and plus 500 defense to now attack and defense plus 10%. Solid Support goes from 10% attack and attacked enemies defense minus 15% to 10% attack and all enemies defense minus 15%. So not just the attacked enemy, but all enemies that you're facing will lose 15% defense. Infighter goes from attack plus 10%, attacked enemies defense minus 10% to attack plus 10% and all enemies defense minus 10%. And then Frieza's minions goes from 300 attack to 20% attack. Dodan Ray goes from 2,000 attack when super attack is launched to 10% attack when performing a super attack. And then Kamehameha goes from 2,500 attack when super attack is launched to 5% attack when performing a super attack. Frieza's army goes from 1,000 defense to 20% defense. Peppa's Nails goes from 1,500 defense to 15% defense. Speedy Retribution goes from 300 attack to 10% attack. Tag Team Materia goes from 500 attack to 15% attack. And RR Army goes from 300 attack to 10% defense. Why do I keep getting these mixed up? To 10% attack. And then Resurrection F goes from 700 attack to 10% attack. New Frieza Army goes from 1,000 attack and 1,000 defense to 20% attack and defense. Power Bestowed by God goes from 2,500 attack when launching a super attack to 5% attack when performing a super attack. Limit Breaking Form goes from 2,000 attack when launching a super to 5% attack when launching a super. Legendary Power goes from 5,000 attack when super attack is launched to 10% attack when performing a super attack. And then there's also Supreme Power that goes from Activate Penetration, Attack and Defense plus 1,000 to Activate Penetration, Attack and Defense plus 5%. And finally, Telekinesis goes from Enemies Defense minus 10% to All Enemies Defense minus 10%. Wait, I think all the effect is the same. Okay, so it's just the text. It's just the explanation. The actual effect is the same for Telekinesis. But for the other ones, they do all get buffed. They all go from either like a flat boost to a percentage boost, or they go from, you know, just only the attacked enemy to all enemies defense debuff or something like that. Essentially, these all are just better links now, even though a lot of these are kind of niche, like some of them are just not used by a lot of units, but still an upgrade is definitely good. These were definitely needed. because flat boosts are just, especially like tiny flat boosts like 300 or 500, they're just not really relevant anymore. So I'm glad they did that. All right, so that is the changes to some of the link skills. And then there's also a few changes to the actual way that links interact with each other and the way that, you know, links kind of work. So it says here, the effects and activation timing of link skills will also be adjusted. Certain link skills powers will also be adjusted. So I'm not really gonna go through all of these. I mean, I'll quickly read them. I'm not gonna like go in depth here, but the first thing here says link skills that raise attack or defense. When a link skill that raises attack or defense is activated, its effect will be determined by the character's link skill level. So essentially, if you have two units that link or share a link, and let's say it's Fierce Battle, for example, then each individual unit will get the effect from the level of their link skill. So for example, if one unit has a level 10 Fierce Battle, then they'll get the effect of a level 10 Fierce Battle. Whereas if the other unit has like a level 2 Fierce Battle, they'll get the effect for the level 2 Fierce Battle. So it's not like they both get, you know, the highest level or the lowest level. It's just they'll get whatever effect that their link level is. Next is link skills that raise ki. And it says, when a link skill that raises ki is activated, its effect will be determined by the character's link skill level. So same thing as the attack and defense links. Essentially here, the Kalkin Goku has a level 2 over in a flash, and the full power Frieza has a level 1 over in a flash. So the Goku will get the level 2 effect, and the Frieza will get the level 1 effect. Alright, from there we have link skills that reduce the enemy's defense, and it says when a link skill that reduces the enemy's defense is activated, the effect of neighboring characters will not be combined, and only the link skill of the character whose link skill level is higher will be activated. So let's say you have two units that share telekinesis as a link, which reduces the enemy's defense, right? It's only the higher level link that gets applied, or the link effect that gets applied to the enemy's defense. And after that, we have link skills that recover HP. When a link skill that recovers HP is activated, the effect of the neighboring characters will not be combined, and only the link skill of the character whose link skill level is higher will be activated. Okay, and then after that, we have link skills activated when performing super attacks. When neighboring characters possess a link skill of the same name, only the link skill effect of the character who is about to perform a super attack will be activated. Which, you know, makes a lot of sense, because it does say in the link that it only activates when performing a super attack. So if a unit is not performing a super attack, then it makes sense that they don't get that boost from the link, right? And I think that is pretty much it. So yeah, that about covers it for this section. Those are some of the adjustments that are coming to the link system in the game in general. And I know it's a little bit boring, it's not that exciting, but it's definitely important to still know. And obviously I'm still much more excited for just the link skill level system in general. But that about does it for today's video, guys. We've talked about everything that's in the news. We also quickly went over what the link skill level system actually will look like, what it's, how it works. And I hope you guys are excited, because if you couldn't tell, definitely am. I don't think, like I said, there is a actual date, unless I missed it. Yeah, I don't think there's an actual date for when this update will come through, but like I said, since it's already in the news, it should be in a couple days, maybe a week at the most, but still a lot sooner than I originally anticipated. So yeah, get hyped, guys. I can't wait. A lot of content on the way for sure. Expect tons of streams. I might just stream like daily until all the units I want to max out are maxed out. Expect to see this face a lot more often after this update drops. But yeah, that's the video, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Hope you guys are excited. As always, if you guys liked today's video, then make sure to like the damn video. And if it's your first time watching me, first time to the channel, and you like what you see, then definitely hit that big red subscribe button to join the Tiger Squad now. And while you're at it, hit that notification bell too, so that YouTube knows you want to stay up to date with all my latest content. And that's it. I'm out of here. Until next time, hope you guys have a fantastic, fantastic day. I'm Tiger with Tiger Uppercut Media, signing out.